फर्स्ट इज वेनस सिस्टम ऑफ लोअर लिम्ब. नाउ कंसंट्रेट ऑन दिस पिक्चर. द आवर अपर लिम्ब एज वेल एज द लोअर लिम्ब बोथ हैज गॉट ड्यूअल वेनस सिस्टम, दैट इज सुपरफिशियल एज वेल एज डीप वेनस सिस्टम. This picture shows the superficial venous system. Okay. This, here you can see this is an arch on the dorsal aspect of the foot. This is dorsal venous arch. Dorsal venous arch unite with, this is first dorsal metatarsal vein. Both this unite to form on the medial aspect. This is great saphenous vein. So great saphenous vein is formed by the union of dorsal venous arch situated on the dorsal aspect of the foot and the first metatarsal vein. Now it ascend upward and meanwhile at the level of just below the medial malleolus it receives one tributary, that is medial marginal vein. And now it passes in front of the medial malleolus. This relation is very important, that in front of medial malleolus. Now it is ascending upward on the anterior aspect of leg and near the knee joint it goes posterior. So I am showing the dotted line. Here is the dotted line and now again it comes on the anterior aspect of thigh and it opens into here in this green one. That is the common femoral vein, which is formed by the union of superficial femoral vein and the deep femoral vein. So this is our great saphenous vein. And on the lateral aspect, this dorsal venous arch forms the short saphenous vein. Receive tributary, that is the lateral marginal vein. And ascend behind. Ascend behind the lateral malleolus and then it goes posterior in the leg, posterior aspect but laterally, that is the short saphenous vein, and now opens finally into the popliteal vein. This is the superficial venous system. In the leg, this great saphenous vein receives this anterior vein of leg. And posteriorly, this one is posterior vein of leg, where my cursor is going, okay? Anterior and posterior vein of leg. And in the thigh, here it receives anterolateral. This is the anterolateral vein. And posteriorly, there is posteromedial vein, this one. And now it opens. So this is our superficial venous system. Deep venous system follows the arterial system, same as that of the arterial system. And pathway of venous drainage, it is superficial vein to the deep vein via the perforators. And then from deep vein to the inferior vena cava to the heart. And there is one mnemonic I made for you people, that Hunt Dad's Boy's Pocket in May. These are the perforators from superior to inferior aspect. Hunt, that is Hunterian perforator, connecting the superficial and the deep vein at the level of adductor canal or Hunterian canal. Dad, that is Dot's perforator. Here you can see this is Dot's perforator situated in the lower one third of the thigh, connecting superficial and deep venous system. Third one is the Boyd's perforator in the upper one third of the leg. Pocket, that means it is homonymous with the Cockett. Cockett's perforator, they are 2 to 3 in number in the lower part of the leg. connecting the superficial and the deep one. And lastly, the may perforator at the level of ankle joint. There is, here it is not shown, may perforator. Okay. So these are the perforator which connect the superficial with the deep venous system. Clinical significance. There are many one-way valve in the superficial vein, deep vein, as well as in the perforating vein, which allows blood to flow from superficial to deep venous system. If they become incompetent, it will lead to backward flow. And here you can see in this picture, there is engorged, tortuous superficial vein, which is known as varicose vein. Due to the incompetent valve or damaged valve, this is normal valve which allows one way flow of the blood, that is from superficial to deep. But due to the damaged valve, the deep will come into the blood from the deoxygenated blood from the deep venous system come into superficial, and it will lead to engorged tortuous superficial vein, that is varicose.